How time flies. So soon we are seeing the last Saturday of the month of November 2020. And in another 1 month or thereabout, we will be bidding farewell to 2020. Not to worry, it is not late to bring fruition your dreams for the year 2020 into reality. Anyways, welcome to today's installment of your Weekend Elysia on television, the independent television weekend news magazine. We have carefully selected stories for your weekend delight, and in the inside pages, Igbinedion University Okada has continued to blaze the trail in tertiary education in Nigeria as the country's premier private university. Today convocated its 18th set of graduates, with hundreds of students conferred with degrees and prizes. The Inspector General Police has vowed not to allow another violent protest to hit Nigeria again. And while that is on, Nigerians are reacting to the recession that has visited the country's economy. Wait for this, there is this community that just got electricity for the first time after over 200 years of existence. Don't worry, I will let you know the community inside the news magazine. Good evening and welcome. I'm Philip Omogupo. The Inspector General Police Mohammed Adamu has vowed never to leave room for any violent protest in the country. IGP Adamu made a declaration during a meeting he had with the commissioners of police across the country in Abuja for a review of the recent NSAS protest, which became violent after it was hijacked by angry youths. At the meeting, the first physical one with the senior officers in months because of the COVID-19 pandemic, Adamu said the police would never allow any kind of violent protest again in any part of the country and are prepared to face anyone that attempts to disrupt the peace. The Inspector General Police at the meeting with senior police officers noted that criminals seized the opportunity provided by the NSAS protest to get back at the police for bringing them to justice. It's in convocation ceremony of Nigeria's premier private university, Igbinedion University, Okada, has been held with the conferment of awards of first degree and prizes of graduating students. Kingsley Uchegbu reports that there was award of high degrees to over 600 graduates in various colleges in the institution.
Arrival of the Chancellor and Founder Igbinedion University Okada, His Excellency Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Osaro Igbinedion, the Asama of Benin, and procession involving Deputy Chancellor and former two-time Governor of Edo State Chief Lucky Nosakara Igbinedion, members of Governing Council, Vice Chancellor Igbinedion University Okada, Professor Lawrence Ezemoye, and other dignitaries heralded activities for the 18th convocation ceremony of the prestigious institution in Okada. Deputy Chancellor Chief Lucky Igbinedion, on behalf of the Chancellor, declared the 18th convocation open. Chief Lucky Nosakara Igbinedion, who read the speech of the Chancellor and the Esama of Benin, His Excellency Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Osaro Igbinedion, said the institution stands out for its uninterrupted academic calendar and one of the few institutions in the country with uninterrupted power supply. He said Igbinedion University Okada has invested funds in various areas of research and development in line with global best practices.
If you enroll for 4 years, you graduate in 4 years. If you enroll for 5 years, you graduate in 5 years. And also by the magnanimity of our Chancellor, Igbinedion University is probably one of the few universities in this nation that has uninterrupted power supply. Igbinedion University is currently addressing a critical phase of our national life by building capacity through entrepreneurship. The idea is to ensure that every graduate of the university is trained on a skill that will make him or her self-reliant and ultimately become employer of labor. It is instructive that the Igbinedion University is the first university in Nigeria to blaze the trail in entrepreneurship education as an academic discipline.
In their remarks, Vice-Chancellor Igbinedion University Okada, Professor Lawrence Ezemoye, and Pro-Chancellor and Chairman Governing Council, Professor Sheikh Abdullah, said despite the challenge of COVID-19, the institution excelled by adopting online teaching activities to enable students continue to learn and enjoy a smooth academic calendar without disruptions.
And we are planning to join other graduates to support the growth of this university. The current member of the leadership is wonderful. And this is because our blue sky graduates are winning the war. We also are going to play. But for God, people would have been talking about loss academic session. That is not so with us. Because God has permitted an uninterrupted academic session.
I must quickly commend the Vice Chancellor and his team, who despite the lockdown liberated on the university's smart campus to conduct online teaching after the general lockdown of the universities in March 2020, culminating in the successful conclusion of the session.
Guest speaker and chairman Access Bank PLC, Dr. Dere Awoshika, delivered the convocation lecture titled Navigating the Entrepreneurship Employability Waters, Building Resilience in the Fourth Industrial Revolution.
Businesses and working population must realistically anticipate, position themselves to harness the opportunities embedded in 4IR, adopt policies to counter the negative effects of this technology towards maximizing the net gain from the 4IR. I therefore implore you as tomorrow's future, in like manner as our father, Chief Igbinedion, has done, in the same approach, Warren Buffett, Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, Mark Zuckerberg, you have to start something or join in the building of that system.
In appreciation of the scholarly lecture, and keeping to the tradition of hospitality of the institution, the Chancellor, Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Osaro Igbinedion, presented a plaque to the guest lecturer. He also announced the naming of a 1,000-bed capacity hostel after Dr. Dere Awoshika.
What a wonderful lecture. I appreciate you, the government.
High Point was a presentation of graduates from various colleges and admittance by the Deputy Chancellor, Chief Lucky Nosakare Igbinedion. First class graduates were also honored. Chancellor of the institution and the SMA of Benin personally presented scrolls to PhD graduates.
Instead, disciplined, determined, focused, and bold driven, nothing would be impossible for us.
16 graduates made first class, 177 graduates made upper credits, 247 graduates made second class lower division, while no third class was recorded for the 2019 and 2020 academic session. Kingsley Uchebu reporting.
Meanwhile, Nigeria's premier private university, Igbinedion University Okada, has again been commended for its remarkable academic record, which ensures timely graduation of students in the country. Some guests and parents of some graduated students made the remark today during the 18th graduation ceremony of the Ivory Tour. The colorful event, which attracted several dignitaries to Okada town, afforded some traders the opportunity to make brisk business. Roslyn Eborame, who captured the sights and sound of the event, has details.
And the deputy.
procession of the Vice Chancellor, professors and top management staff of Igbinedion University, Okada, to the main auditorium of the institution venue of the graduation ceremony. The Chancellor of Igbinedion University and Honorary Romano Consul to Edore and Delta State, the ASMR of Benin, Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Osawa Igbinedion, and the Deputy Vice Chancellor of the University and two-time Governor of Edo State, Chief Lucky Igbinedion, were given a warm welcome by the Vice Chancellor, Professor Lawrence Ezemoye, top management staff of the institution and the students. Invited guests, parents and students, as well as the staff of Igbinedion University, Okada, adhered strictly to COVID-19 protocol by wearing face masks, ensured their hands were washed, and maintained social distancing during the events. Policemen and other security agencies were on the ground to ensure adequate security. Some students, after collecting their certificate, danced to the admiration of their parents and guests. Parents and graduates appreciated God for their successful graduation from a reputable world-class institution, Igbinedion University, Okada. They also expressed gratitude to the management of Igbinedion University for teaching them online during the lockdown in parts of the country because of COVID-19.
Igbinedion is a great man. The school is great. Igbinedion is a man who saw tomorrow. He saw tomorrow, I conquer tomorrow today. I congratulate him.
Everything I see here is beautiful. Most children are at home now due to ASU strike. 4 years is 4 years here. 6 years is 6 years here. So there is no strike, no nothing. In fact, I would recommend this school for anybody.
I feel happy, I feel blessed because it is God. Because it look as at the beginning of this year, it looks as if it will not come to pass, but I thank God today is a reality.
I'm very happy. So I will just tell every other person coming up to just work hard. Being in the University of God, of course, number one, the best.
I feel happy with the fact that I have finished school, I've graduated with a good degree. I want to thank you to the school for giving this opportunity. I meet amazing people.
To be graduating today, despite the pandemic, it's a feat. And I commend the school management for being able to rise above it.
It was a hive of activities at the premises of Igbinedion University, Okada, as parents of the graduates entertained their invited guests and family members. Some personalities at events include the Deputy Governor of Edo State, Comrade Philip Shuaibu, represented by the Chairman of Ovia Southwest Local Government, Destiny Inabulele, a representative of the Catholic Archbishop of Benin Metropolitan See, His Grace, Most Reverend Augustine Akubezi, amongst others.
There is no doubt that Igbinedion University, the Nigerian's premier private university, has over the years produced thousands of graduates who are doing well in their various fields of study. This year, over 600 students graduated from different colleges and departments of the institution. Igbinedion University, known for the best, pursue excellence in teaching, research and scholarship through the provision of world-class facilities to everyone without any form of discrimination. From the main auditorium, Igbinedion University, Okada, Roslyn Ewurame, reporting.
A full broadcast of the 18th convocation of Igbinedion University, Okada, will come your way at 9 p.m. tonight. Do stay tuned. We'll take a short break.
Obituary. With gratitude to God for a life well spent, the family of late Chief A.E. Osunde announces the passing of our beloved matriarch, Deaconess Alice Omoariagbon Omouyi Osunde, which sad event occurred on the 24th of November 2020. She was the last of the Titans, a total woman. May her gentle soul rest in perfect peace. Amen. Details of our final rest will be announced later. This is signed by Osunde and Omoyi families.
I'm not It's my party jollof.
It's my signature.
It's our signature.
New Maggie signature. The complete cooking mix comes in jollof, pottage, and mia variants.
Look at my life. Can you see what God has done?
The annual Harvest Thanksgiving service of Jesus Breeds Ministries International Incorporated holds on Sunday, 29 November 2020 at 10 a.m. prompt under the distinguished chairmanship of Brother Felix Lator and Pastor Patu Swanili. Theme, God of Restoration, Jewel 225. Special guest of honor, His Excellency, Sir Chief Dr. Gabriel Osawari Benedion, CFRO, the Esama of Benin Kingdom, and the Honorary Romanian Counselor to Edo and Delta States. Guest speaker, Dr. Iseme Okundayi, Mother of the Day, Madam Dora Aibangbe, Father of the Day, Elder I.A. Osayende. Day for the annual Harvest Thanksgiving Service 2020, Sunday, 29 November 2020. Venue number 4 to 16 Osayi Street, off Ewa Road, off Upper Mission Road, Benin City. To welcome you is the chief host, Bishop Dr. Eddie Omowuyi Okundayi, J.P. Host, Pastor Benson Aihalumele. God bless you as you come. Signed, Elder Emmanuel Egyamusoi, Committee Chairman. Mama,
you gave life to me. With heavy hearts, but with total submission to the Almighty God, we announce the relocation to the heavens of our wife, mother, grandmother, late senior prophetess Ijose Aigbekan, at the age of 64. She is survived by her husband, Mr. Egato Aigbekan, children, Mr. Amadi Aigbekan, Mr. Agawa Aigbekan, Mrs. Eriagbonse Obakawaye, and Mr. Ehis Aigbekan. Funeral arrangements, Monday 30th November 2020. Body leaves God's Care Mortuary to her residence, 50 First Ihogbe Street, off Wire Road, Benin City. 4 p.m. service of song, Tuesday, December 1st, 2020, 10 a.m. Body leaves her residence to her hometown, Ile Ekpoma. Saturday, 5th December 2020, social dance at number 50 First Ihogbe Street, off Wire Road, Benin City. 6th December 2020, 9 a.m. Thanksgiving service at Word of Liberation Fire Ministry, Second Power Line, Ugbeyoko, Benin City. Reception at number 50 First Ihogbe Street, off Wire Road, Benin City. May her gentle soul rest in perfect peace. Sign, Mr. Amadi Aigbekan, for the family.
1 year in mind, in evergreen memory of our dearly beloved father, grandfather, great-grandfather, Pa Daniel Unamore Agmomare. Daddy, we remember you today as always. You touched us in so many ways we cannot forget in a hurry. Your legacy of hospitality, hard work, honesty, sincerity, and integrity, which we have imbibed, stands you out as a unique personality. You indeed left your mark in the sands of time. We love you, Daddy, but God loves you more. We are confident and rest assured that you are resting in the bosom of the Lord. We miss you dearly, fondly remembered by your lovely children and grandchildren. Signed, Children.
Andrew Obosa Amadi Elias Amasco. Baba, it is exactly 1 year that you departed this world. Your wife and children remember you today as always. How can we ever forget your good leg? We success are forever. We wish to thank all and just let us support the road of our company and the special love. I think please remain available. Father, me, your mother, father, come on, father, and say, back, father, and say, Okafo, father, Jero, Lady, the auntie, father, Philip, father, Harry, I will only pass Rosalie, Mr. Amazon, Mr. Amazon, H. and more, her daughter, Mrs. Demonia Greg, at Doris, Amazon, Humphrey, and Amazon, the Amazon.
Do you place street good food for your home and wants low rent condition? Very wanted on the all hot action. All set. Tent. Our friend the Jitsum and Sikha. We both empty. We are open from 8 to 9 p.m. Monday to Sunday. Home and Away Restaurant. We are located at number 1 Ikpokwa Road, off Sapla Road, GRA, Benin City. For more information, please call 0708-849-1281 or 0901-603-2522. Home and Away Restaurant. Total satisfaction and more.
Some Benin City residents have attributed the country's second recession to the negative effect of the COVID-19 and the recent anti-SARS protest. Iponosa Ogiagbe has more.
Nigeria's economy fell into recession in 2016 for the first time in two decades and recovered in 2017, but has been slowing down since then. The IMF said it expects Nigeria's GDP to decline by 5.4% in 2020, while the government envisaged a contraction of 8.9%. Nigeria, which is Africa's biggest economy, entered recession for the second time in 4 years. Some Benin City residents attributed the development to the fall in oil prices as well as the negative impact on the economy by the coronavirus pandemic and the recent NSAS protests in the country.
Towards the end of last year, 2019, there was a pandemic that started in China that spread all over the world, crumbling the economy of the entire world. So that in itself has a ripple effect and a trickle-down effect on the Nigerian economy. Recently, a mass of the youth of our people came outside to protest against police activities. That again crumbled the economy of Nigeria for about 2 weeks.
We just managed to come out from the COVID pandemic and the protest and everything. When a country has not worked for about 6 months, output falls down quite naturally. And in economics, what we do, if we have negative growth for two successive quarters, we call it a recession.
The respondents proffer solution on what should be done for the economy to recover from recession.
Some years ago, the world witnessed a Great Depression. Nigeria should go and learn from what the world did, what leaders did that time for the world to come out of the effect of that Great Depression.
The government should pump more money into the economy in the form of palliatives, because one of the reasons why there's a recession is because there's a dampening of aggregate demand. People are not buying things, they don't have money to buy things. So what the government does at times like this is to pump more money into critical sectors that drive growth. And in Nigeria, the critical sectors that drive growth are the oil sector, the agricultural sector, and basic manufacturing.
Ikmomosa Ugiagbe reporting.
Meanwhile, the Central Bank of Nigeria has predicted that the nation's economy may emerge from recession in the first quarter of 2021. CBN Governor Godwin Emefiele, who made a prediction during the 55th annual Bankers' Dinner, which held in Lagos, noted that the expected economic growth was 2%. The CBN Governor also called for measures to insulate the economy from the impact of shocks through diversification efforts, while also working to ensure that Nigerians adhere to safety protocols in order to prevent a surge in COVID-19-related cases, as this could further cripple economic activities. Emefiele's remarks come 6 days after Nigeria's economy slipped into another recession, the second of its kind in a space of 4 years.
Appeal to Nigerians, particularly our media economic analysts, we confess that the problem we face today is of global dimension, and Nigeria is not alone. The global economy is today challenged, so Nigerian economy is not alone challenged. Although the 2016-2017 recession was challenging for the authorities.
We take a short break on the Weekend News magazine. Do stay tuned.
Hey! Our meeting said they go share rice for everybody for this Christmas.
Yo, rice care. You dey make me laugh. This Christmas, now generate our cooperative. One share for everybody.
Ewo! I need generator for my business.
No worry. Now for Uyi Technica, them say them buy to share for all of us. And say Uyi Technica, they do Christmas bonanza right now. And everybody fit collect generator for bonanza prize.
Christmas generator bonanza for Uyi Technica? Hey! Oh yeah, carry me go!
Now in be this so, Uyi Technica, the generator headquarters.
Uyi Technica Christmas bonanza. Opportunity for everybody to get generator for cheap bonanza prize. Every size and brand of generator with genuine spare parts, grinding machine and pepper mill, including sewing machine and others. Come buy generators for cheap Christmas price for Uyi Technica Limited, 7981 and 83 Mission Road, Benin City. Uyi Technica Generator Bonanza. Now light for everybody this Christmas.
It is true that beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder. Oh yes, now that you have seen it, go redefine your home with EDS quality paints. We have emulsion, glossy, test coat, stucco, superior matte, super satin, high quality emulsion. Oh yes, it is quality, no fade, no stain. EDS quality paints is widely recommended, preferred and used. We have beautiful colors from our variety of paints. to give your homes, offices, hotels, schools a beautiful look. Come, visit us today at along Amagwa Road, Amagbajirue, Benin City. Along Upper Sakumba Road by Ebba Village. Come at 22 Adesuwa Road, opposite Etete Junction. Or visit our head office at Kilometer 12, Benin Sapley Road by Oruwa Village, Benin City. EDS Quality Paint redefines your home.
This is for the information of the general public. Owners of clubs, bars, lounges, restaurants, event centers, hotels, shopping malls, transport companies, broadcast stations, and similar establishments, that it is unlawful for anyone to use music in any trade or business or to support same without authorization or license from Musical Copyright Society of Nigeria, MCSN. This is in line with the Copyright Act, LFN 2004, the Copyright Collective Management Organizations Regulation 2007. It is therefore a compelling necessity for users of music in public places or commercial settings, including members of Association of Hotel Proprietors of Edo State, to immediately proceed to MCSN office at 23 MM Way Benin City and obtain the required music copyright license to avoid copyright wahala. It is cheaper to obtain music copyright license from MCSN than the double wahala associated with copyright violation. Signed, Prince Biodun Ewakide, MCSN Edo Delta State Coordinator.
The federal government, through its Rural Electrification Agency, today announced the provision of electricity to Oloji Community, Ijebu East, Ogun State, for the first time since the community came into existence 200 years ago. It said residents of the community experienced power supply for the first time on Friday with the official inauguration of a 100-kilowatt solar-powered off-grid electricity system by the Rural Electrification Agency. The agency, in a statement issued in Abuja by its spokesman, Mokhtar Ibrahim, said the remote community had about 4,500 residents. It stated that local leaders in the community said there had never been power supply in the area, as residents had never used basic home appliances because of the absence of electricity since the community was first discovered. And that wraps it on the Saturday edition of the Weekend News Magazine on Independent Television. Thanks for your time. I'm Philip Omogupo. Good night and enjoy the rest of your weekend.
Independent Television News. Truly independent.
Attention to hear from God. God's Grace Ministry Inc.